Mr. Vice Chairman, at the very outset, I wish to congratulate our Finance Minister for presenting a very balanced, very thought out and very well planned budget, which has been hailed by almost all sections of the society for one reason or the other. It is no doubt a people-oriented and growth-oriented budget, which is entirely in consonance with the objectives of the 7th five-year plan, namely food, work and productivity. Sir, the beauty of the budget and the ingenuity of the finance minister lie in the fact that although outlays for development purposes have been augmented and numerous concessions have been allowed in respect of various items of daily use by men, women and children, the dose of taxation is not heavy and its impact on the common man will be almost negligible. Para. The budget proposals aim at benefiting the rural poor, generating more employment, especially in the rural sector, where about 75% of our population lives, and promoting villages and small scale industries. That is why, sir, the Patriot has called it a people-oriented budget. The Hindustan Times found it a Jai Kisan budget. The Financial Express has welcomed it as a farmer-oriented budget, and the Hindu has hailed it as sound exercise under the circumstances. Even the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry and Associated Chambers of Commerce have welcomed it as a growth-oriented budget. Moreover, it is a fact in view of the drought conditions prevailing in many parts of the country for the last few years. It had become necessary for the government to boost food production and revitalize the agricultural economy, without which industrial growth cannot be ensured. If the farmers do not have the purchasing power, industrial growth cannot be maintained either. Para. Therefore, it is a matter of great satisfaction that the central government is fully alive to the actual requirements of the people of the country and has taken due care of the farmers and the rural sector without putting any additional burden on the industrial sector. The reduction in the rate of interest on crop loan between 10% and 25%, arrangement of additional credit of rupees 3,000 crores for agriculture by the public sector, banks discount of 7% over notified prices for fertilizers will go a long way in increasing our agricultural production.